हेलो डियर लर्नर्स, माई सेल्फ विपुल कुमार डी प्रजापति, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एंड HOD फार्मास्यूटिक्स, SSR कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी, सिलवासा, वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस सेशन 9 ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल इंजीनियरिंग कोर्स अबाउट डिस्कशन ऑफ लीफ फिल्टर, अ टाइप ऑफ बैच प्रोसेस फिल्ट्रेशन इक्विपमेंट. द ड्राइविंग फोर्स ऑफ दिस इक्विपमेंट इज प्रेशर. So positive pressure is the main driving force of leaf filter. With vacuum it can also work. So let's start about learning of leaf filter. What are the learning outcomes? After this session 9, you will be able to understand about a pressure vessel leaf filters. Originally it was known as a door Oliver Kelly filters. They were used extensively in Australian gold operation but are now seldom used in various industries. The leaves are grooved plated over which filtering medium made of knitted clothes like hessian, canvas, wooden sheets or fabric materials are enclosed. So in this session you will be able to understand about a pressure vessel leaf filters principle, construction, working, merits, demerits and various uses. When a pressure vessel leaf filter is selected, they are generally used for handling of incompressible or slightly compressible cakes, because there are two main categories of pressure filters. The pressure filters are generally an enclosed vessel in which we can easily handle any type of volatile liquid components and hazardous toxic materials. The two categories of pressure filters are as: first one is plate and frame filter press, and second is pressure vessels containing filter elements or leaves. And under this, cartridge filters are also available. So pressure vessels containing filter elements are required to learn because it only handle the incompressible or slightly compressible cakes. When both type of cakes are required to handle, then plate and frame filter press is used. So here, what is the main use of pressure vessel leaf filters? To handle incompressible and slightly compressible cakes only. So when we select these types of filtration, when an efficient solid liquid separation at minimum flow space for large filtration areas is required. When the volatile liquids are there in a slurry containing less than 5% weight by volume solids, and filtration is required. When there is a risk of environmental hazard from toxic, flammable or volatile cakes during filtration unit operation. At that time, these types of leaf filter is used and secured discharge mechanisms can be used. When high filtration clarity is required for polished liquid preparation or application, this type of filtration equipment is used. When handling saturated brines that require elevated temperatures, at that time these types of filtration equipment is used. At that time, the tank or vessel may be steam jacketed. When the batch scale discharge of the filter cake is required, either as a dry or wet cake form from a slurry containing less than 5% weight by volume solids, means dilute suspension. So in all these conditions, दिस इज अ चॉइस ऑफ फिल्ट्रेशन इक्विपमेंट दैट इज प्रेशर वेसल कंटेनिंग लीफ फिल्टर्स. वॉट इज द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ अ लीफ फिल्टर? इट इज अ टाइप ऑफ सरफेस फिल्ट्रेशन एंड हैंस इट वर्क्स ऑन द प्रिंसिपल और मैकेनिज्म ऑफ स्ट्रेनिंग और स्क्रीनिंग मीन्स सीव लाइक मैकेनिज्म. लार्ज और कोर साइज पार्टिकल्स ऑफ अ स्लरी दैट आर रिटेन ऑन द सरफेस ऑफ द फिल्टर मीडिया दैट इज फिल्टर लीव्स. दैट फिल्टर लीव्स आर हैविंग स्मॉल पोर साइज सो डिपेंड्स ऑन द पोर साइज दैट रिटेन द सॉलिड्स ऑन इट्स सरफेस सो दैट्स वाई इट इज टाइप ऑफ सरफेस फिल्ट्रेशन. टू एनहांस द रेट ऑफ फिल्ट्रेशन प्रेशर और वैक्यूम इज अप्लाइड मीन्स इट वर्क्स यूजिंग अ ड्राइविंग फोर्स आइदर पॉजिटिव प्रेशर और स्लाइट वैक्यूम फॉर बैच प्रोसेस पर्पज ओनली नॉट फॉर कंटिन्यूस ऑपरेशन. वॉट इज द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ अ प्रेशर लीफ फिल्टर इक्विपमेंट फॉर सॉलिड लिक्विड फिल्ट्रेशन बैच प्रोसेस? They are designed for final discharge of solids in either a dry or a wet state under totally enclosed condition with fully automatic operation. Each type of pressure leaf filter equipment features, first part is a pressure vessel in which one or more filter elements commonly known as leaves are located. As shown in this figure, the number of filter elements or filter leaves are arranged parallel to each other in a vertical pressure vessel. This image shows the filter leaf. So number of filter leaf are arranged parallel to each other in this pressure vessel. So it consists of a number of filter leaves, mostly rectangular, square or circular in a shape. A number of such filter leaves are supported on one or more common rails inside this vertical shape pressure vessel and placed in such a way so distance is required to maintain to get desired thickness of the cake. As shown in figure, on the top of this pressure vessel the filter leaves are held by a common vibrating shaft. A mechanical vibrator driven by either electric motor or pneumatic vibrator is provided for vibrating the leaf shaft for cake discharge. So whatever the solids deposited on each filter leaf with the help of mechanical vibrator we can collect the filter cake at the bottom concept part of this vertical vessel and that can be discharged through cake discharge at the bottom of this vessel. Jacket for hot filtration can be offered if desired overflow vent or steam or air charging. Pressure gauge and safety valve are provided on the top. The top cover is provided with davit arm mechanism for raising the door or lid for cleaning or removing the leaves. Eye bolts are provided for quick opening and closing of top door or lid. What are the main parts of a filter leaf equipment? लीफ फिल्टर इक्विपमेंट कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू मेन पार्ट्स. द फर्स्ट पार्ट इज नोन एज द नंबर ऑफ फिल्टर लीव्स एंड दे आर कॉमनली नोन एज द मेन एलिमेंट्स ऑफ फिल्टर लीफ. एंड सेकंड पार्ट इज नोन एज अ वेसल और अ टैंक. इट मे बी हॉलो सिलिंड्रिकल इन शेप. देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ वेसल अवेलेबल. वन इज वर्टिकल टाइप एंड सेकंड इज हॉरिजॉन्टल शेप टाइप. नाउ वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट फिल्टर लीव्स कंस्ट्रक्शन. ईच फिल्टर लीव और इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज एन एलिमेंट कंटेनिंग फर्स्ट पार्ट फाइव लेयर्स और पैड्स ऑफ डिफरेंट गॉज मैस एंड सेकंड अ नैरो मेटालिक टबलर फ्रेम. सो ईच फिल्टर लीफ और एलिमेंट मे बी ऑफ सर्क्यूलर स्क्वायर और रेक्टेंगुलर इन शेप डिपेंडिंग ऑन द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ सॉलिड लिक्विड बैच प्रोसेस फिल्ट्रेशन पर्पस. एंड दे आर मेड अप ऑफ मेटल सच एज आइदर स्टेनलेस स्टील और कार्बन स्टील. फाइनर फिल्टरिंग मीडियम मेड ऑफ नीटेड क्लोथ लाइक हेजियन फैब्रिक. वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ हेजियन फैब्रिक? इन यूनाइटेड स्टेट, कैनेडा एंड इन इंडिया इट इज अ वोवन फैब्रिक मेड फ्रॉम द स्किन ऑफ द जूट और सीसल फाइबर्स. सेकंड कैनवास फैब्रिक. कैनवास फैब्रिक मीन्स इट इज अ प्लेन वोवन फैब्रिक मेड अप ऑफ कॉटन विथ लेस एक्सटेंट ऑफ लिनन. दे आर ऑल्सो द फिल्टर मीडियम ऑल्सो मेड अप ऑफ वुलन सीड्स और मेटालिक मैस और समटाइम्स सिंथेटिक पॉलीमर स्क्रीन इज ऑल्सो यूज. वॉट इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ अ कंप्लीट प्रेशर लीफ फिल्टर एलिमेंट? सो एज वी नो वेरी वेल ईच फिल्टर लीफ कंसिस्ट ऑफ फायर लेयर्स ऑफ डिफरेंट गॉज वायर मैस सच एज द फर्स्ट सेंट्रल कोर्स ड्रेन मैस. सो इट इज अ सेंट्रल पोर्शन द सेंट्रल कोर्स ड्रेन मैस. On both side of this central coarse drain mass, there are two layers of supporting mass and then two layers of fine filter mass. So as shown in this figure, on one side of a leaf filter, in the center there is a coarse mass or it is commonly known as drain screen. On one side, there is one layer of supporting mass and at other side there is one layer of supporting mass. Means there are two layers supporting mass. Then the third layer on this supporting mass, that is the finer filter mass or cloth. It is available on both sides. So in each filter leaf both side filtration occurs and there is the opening. So it is connected with the frame, a tubular frame. So that is known as the canal for filtrate. And the wire mesh material may be of stainless steel or carbon steel. So all layers of this wire mesh are bound together by a tubular frame and are made leak proof by machine riveting or bolting depending on the requirement. The quality of filtration and leaf life depends on the quality of outer fine mesh and riveting. This image shows the front view of filter leaf styles and structures. So these are the different shape filter leaves, screen filter leaf, or that is chamber screen, which contains the portion of the top, that is the filter cloth, that is fine mesh or woven fabric, and the other supporting mass and the central coarse mass is there, and they are fixed on the groove plate and directly connected with the frame, tubular frame. So the different shape filter leaves are available according to the second part of the unit is known as vessel. So when we identify what is the complete structure of a second portion of this filter leaf, that is a narrow metallic tubular frame. So it is at the bottom and top. So it is directly connected with the central drain canal. So in each leaf filter, the interior of the frame is connected to the outlet for the filtrate through the suction pump. Means a frame is enclosing a drainage screen supported on a metallic grooved plate or ribs of a filter leaf. So through this frame, the liquid is going to flow from drainage screen and it is collected through filtrate outlet in the receiver. The filter leaves with a tubular frames are available in industries as metallic rectangular shape. So frame is the border and the remaining portion is the leaves. That is the circular shape metallic leaf with a tubular metallic frame on the top. This is the rectangular shape commonly available metallic frame. How the arrangement of filter leaves in a vessel as a cross-sectional diagram. So in this image you easily identify how number of filter leaves are arranged in parallel to each other in a vertical vessel with space. So this is the detailed structure of a single filter leaf and the frame, how it is going to connected. So they are going to fixed on the provisions of the filtrate outlet, that is the horizontal axis. So number of filter leaves are fixed on the horizontal axis, which are connected as a one pipe. So from that we can collect the filtrate. The space between the filter leaves or elements in a pressure vessel is required to maintain, because the thickness of the cake depends on the space between the filter leaves. So usually between 30 to 152 millimeter thickness can be maintained by maintaining the space between the leaves. So according to the capacity of a vessel, the number of filter leaves are arranged in sequence and we maintain the space in order to get the final cake thickness. It may vary depending on the cake thickness or formation properties of the cake. Either it may be compressible or incompressible. And the ability of the vacuum to hold a thick or heavy cake to the vertical leaf surface. For fast filtering slurries, the space may be doubled by removing every second plate. So consequently, the cake space doubles, but the filtration area is cut in half, the filter leaves involved in the filtration. So hence, if we require to remove very less percentage solids available in slurry, we have to maintain the distance between the filter leaves in such a way we can easily remove it when it deposited. The next portion of this equipment is known as a metallic vessel or tank. It is a hollow cylindrical shape in structure. They are designed in such a way to hold or arrange several filter leaves with a fixed spacing between them. Example, a 914 millimeter diameter filter vessel can take between 6 to 13 filter leaves, while a 1828 millimeter diameter filter vessel can take or occupy 20 filter leaves. And filtering areas of 100 to 300 square meter operating at pressures up to 600 to 800 kilopascal or 8 bar. Two types of a vessel commonly available. So first one is known as vertical type vessels and second is horizontal type vessels. In most of the fine chemicals processes, the filter leaves are fitted in a vertical vessel. So it is known as vertical vessel, vertical leaf filter. Round cylindrical shape vessel and is ideal for solid or liquid separation and well suited for handling toxic, flammable and corrosive materials. Horizontal vessel is there. It is used in the heavier process industries such as the preparation of sulfur in phosphoric acid plants. It is round cylindrical shape vessel. The filter leaves may be positioned either along the vessel axis or perpendicular to the axis. They are perfect for batch processing applications, which require high flow rates and safe operations with low solids removal. How the arrangement of the filter leaves in a vessel? According to its uses, the desired number of filter leaves of specific size may be circular, rectangular or square and having the desired structure. So they can be fixed parallel to each other into either a vertical pressure leaf filter or a horizontal pressure leaf filter. So the first image is the indication of vertical pressure leaf filter, because the vertical vessel is there in which number of rectangular shaped vertical arrangement of leaf filters. The second image indicates the horizontal vessel in which the vertically arrangement of rectangular shape vertical filter leaves. Hence, four varieties are possible. The first variety is known as vertical vessel, in which vertical filter leaves are arranged in series parallel to each other. Second, horizontal vessel, vertical filter leaves. Third, vertical vessel, horizontal filter leaves. And fourth variety is also possible for this equipment, that is horizontal vessel containing horizontal filter leaves. We are discussing first two. So first one is vertical vessel containing vertical filter leaves. So these types of pressure leaf filter, first figure indicate the complete construction of the pressure leaf filter vertical vessel containing rectangular shaped vertical filters. The center two images shows the filtration mode of these types of filtration equipment. And the last image shows the washing mode of this equipment. So this vertical vessel containing vertical leaves is the cheapest pressure leaf filters and have the lowest volume to area ratio. Their filtration areas are limited to less than 80 square meter. Large bottom outlets fitted with rapid opening doors are used for dry cake discharge, and smaller openings are used for slurry discharge. So there are two types of opening at the bottom of this vertical vessel. One is large opening and second is small opening. So large opening for dry cake discharge purpose and small opening used for slurry discharge, because sometimes during the operation, when the operation is completed, part of the slurry remain, and that is known as heel slurry. So that slurry is required to remove. Wet discharge may be promoted by spray pipes, vibrators, reverse flow, bubble rings, scrapers, etc. Dry discharge is usually caused by vibration. As with all vertical leaf filters, these are not suited for cake washing, because all filter leaves are arranged vertically, so cake washing is not efficient, because during washing cake is going to fall off from the filter leaf. So that's why horizontally arranged filter leaves in vertical vessel or horizontal vessel is there, the washing is very efficient and we can easily maintain the thickness of the cake. So vertical leaf filters in vertical vessel not suited for cake washing. As the head cover of the vertical vessels is often swiveled, hence it is swung away to allow the upward removal of the filter leaves in the stack. A special ring can be designed and practiced for supporting all the filter leaves inside the vertical vessel that is removed from the vessel. Special quick opening bolts are fitted around the head cover, and hence the tightness is secured during filtration operation, but enable easy opening when access to the stack is required. Means whenever we require to stop the operation and remove the head cover, the quick opening bolts are easy to access. An additional scavenger filter element is there at the bottom of the vessel or tank for the filtration of the heel of unfiltered slurry that is still in the vessel at the end of the filtration period. So this residual slurry is commonly known as heel operation, is particularly troublesome with the vertical leaf filters only, because uncompressed air cannot be used to complete the filtration of this heel, as the air would preferentially escape through the tops of the leaves as soon as they emerged from the suspension. During the scavenge filtration, the main leaves are usually isolated so that compressed air is not lost through them. So there is an additional scavenger filter element in vertical vessel containing vertical filter leaves for removing of the residual slurry at the end of filtration period. The second variety of this equipment is horizontal vessel containing vertical filter leaves. In a cylindrical vessel with a horizontal axis, the vertical leaves can be arranged either laterally or longitudinally. It is the earliest pressure leaf filter, commonly known as Kali leaf filter. So this image itself indicates how in horizontal shape hollow cylindrical vessel the number of vertically arranged filter leaves with required space. Its design is suitable for smaller duties and the leaves can be withdrawn individually through the opening end of the vessel. The filtration area up to 120 meter square can be possible. These types of filtration leaf equipment is used for the filtration of very viscous liquids such as glycerol and concentrated sugar solutions. They require a considerable amount of floor space, and to minimize this drawback, the filters are often constructed in pairs of a single runway with their opening ends facing each other. Thus, each filter can be opened in turn into the common space between them. So, horizontal vessel containing vertical filter leaves requires a considerable amount of floor space. For weight discharge purpose, with or without rotation of the leaves, flushing sprays are used. That is the portion of this type of equipment. If the leaves are designed for rotation, they are invariably circular and mounted on a central hollow shaft that serves as the filtrate outlet. Dry cake discharge may be carried out with the rotating leaves by application of a scraper blade. So, scraper blades are used for dry cake discharge purpose. If this is to be done without opening the vessel, then the bottom of the vessel must be shaped as a hopper with a screw conveyor if necessary. There are different variants of a leaf filter unit. So, first one is known as the VertiJet unit with a vertical tank. This figure shows the VertiJet unit with a vertical tank and vertical leaf filter with rectangular shaped leaves mounted individually but connected to a common outlet manifold. For channel cleaning, either a stationary or oscillating jet system using high efficiency spray nozzles is fitted to give complete cake removal. And for recovery of dry solids, vibration of the leaves allows automatic discharge of the solids through a bottom discharge port provided with a quick opening door. So this is the first variant of a vertical vessel containing vertical arrangement of filter leaves. The second variant is the auto jet with circular shape filter leaves. In this design, with circular leaves mounted on a horizontal shaft serving as the filtrate outlet manifold, the leaves are rotated. The leaves are rotated during the cleaning cycle. Although, in addition, extra low speed continuous rotation during operation ensures uniform cake buildup in difficult applications. The leaves may be rotated over knife blades, which remove the cake in a dry stick. In this design, they are used for handling foodstuffs and also for the processing of minerals and effluents. So AutoJet with circular safe filter leaves are used for handling foodstuffs and also for the processing of minerals and effluents. The third variant of a filter unit is a filtramatic unit for handling of edible oils, molten sulfur, effluents and food stuffs. It is used in which either the bundle in retracted from the cell as a unit or the filter tank is retracted, leaving the filter leaves and filter covers in position. These types of units are available in cylindrical, conical or thrust cell configurations, and cleaning may be either wet or dry, manual or automatic. For dry discharge removal, vibration systems are used. For wet discharge removal, spray jets are commonly used, mounted in an overhead manifold. Swap the entire leaf surface in an oscillating motion. The fourth variant is known as the Switland filter. As shown in this figure, it has the cylindrical shape split in a horizontal plane into two parts, where the bottom one half can be swung open for cake discharge. The upper one half is rigidly supported and both the feed and filtrate piping are fixed to it. So upper one half portion is stationary and the lower part is hinged to the upper along one side and is counterbalanced for easy opening. A series of filter leaves suspended in a cylindrical cell and connected to a common outlet to provide a large area for filtration. So in this Switland filter, it consists of assemblies of leaf filters to provide large filtering area, and there is the common outlet for filtrate. New variant of a pressure vessel filter leaves under the development, that is known as horizontal vessel filters with vertical rotating elements, means vertical rotating filter leaves. It has been under rapid development with the aim of making truly continuous pressure filters, particularly for the filtration of fine coal. So fine coal filtration will be possible if that type of provision is there. So it has been under rapid development, that is horizontal vessel filters with vertical rotating elements. Now, after completion of this construction of filter leaf, working of a pressure vessels leaf filter leaves, we are discussing how the working is possible. The working operation is labor intensive and requires a complex manipulation of all valves of the filter leaf unit. Hence, in present day, fully automated installation is carried out to minimize labor exhaustive. Leaves can be the final filtration media, but typically use diatomaceous earth or other filter aids as a pre-coat and or body feed to improve filtration rate and product clarity. So remember, when the sticky gelatinous low proportion of solids are present in any slurry, at that time pre-coating is essential. So pre-coating means nothing, it is the deposition of a fine filter aids on the surface of filter leaves. So on surface of filter leaves, pre-coating layer is deposited, and then the actual slurry's filtration is proceed. So based on the proportion and properties of solids present in the slurry, the working of solid liquid filtration using these types of equipment can be carried out as, first, if for gelatinous sticky fine size solids in low proportion containing slurry, first filtration of pre-coat material, that is filter aid, suitable filter aid, diatomaceous earth, perlite or activated charcoal slurry will be proceed before starting filtration of the actual slurry. Why this pre-coating material is required? To improve the rate of filtration of the actual slurries. Okay, so first pre-coating slurry is required to filter, to deposit it as a filter aid and improve the permeation of filter leaves, and then the actual filtration is carried out. And if the second type of slurry is present for coat size solid particles in low proportion containing slurry, it will be followed directly, so without pre-coating layer applied on the filter leaves, we directly follow the filtration of these types of slurry. What are the different general points required to be remembered during working operation of leaf filter? The material to be filtered is fed into the vessel under pressure, and the separation takes place with the solids being deposited on the leaf surface and the liquid passing through the drainage system and out of the filter. The filters are operated either at constant pressure or constant volume rate. When filtering at constant pressure, filtration is stopped when the filtrate flow is low or negligible. And in case of when filtering at constant flow rate, the pressure drops and filtration rate falls, indicating the end of the operation. So you can select either at constant pressure or at constant volume rate. When the filtration is carried out under vacuum, it is applied through the discharge manifold only. Washing of filter cake for recovery of mother liquor or for removal of soluble may be carried out before discharge of the solids as a wet or a dry cake. Means after filtration, the filter leaves are sometimes removed to a second tank or vessel for washing purpose and subsequently for drying if necessary. But it is not always. Within the same vessel, the provision is there for washing. So according to the available facility, it will be followed. Cycle times are determined either by pressure, cake capacity or batch quantity. When particularly very fine solids are required to remove, a layer of pre-coat material, that is filtrate material, may be deposited on the leaves prior to actual filtration of actual slurry. So commonly diatomaceous earth, perlite or other suitable filter aid materials are used. So pre-coat method of deposition of layers of filtrates is used before filtration of aqueous slurry. Now the time of reflection spot. You have to take your note and pen and write down the answer of this question. What are the common steps of working operation of a pressure vessel containing Leaves filter? Pause the video, think and write down the answer of this question. If you have completed the answer of this question, play the video once again and verify your answer. The common order of working operation of filter leaf. The first step is installation, means number of filter leaves required according to size and shape in the capacity of the vertical or horizontal pressure vessel. The second step is known as deposition of pre-coating layer of filtrate. When a clear sparkle filtrate is required from a very fine solids containing slurry less than 5% weight by volume solid content. So at that time, to improve the efficiency of filtration, pre-coating layer is required. So this image itself indicating how the pre-coating material after stirring the slurry of this pre-coat material, we have to insert it in this vessel and it will be deposited as a uniform thin layer. The thickness in between 2 to 5 mm of this pre-coat material is required to maintain because it improves the pore structure of the filter leaves and the liquid easily pass through these pores. So pre-coat material is required to pour. When the gelatinous or sticky materials are there in actual slurry. Third step is known as filtration of actual slurry. Then fourth step is known as hill removal, means remaining slurry we have to remove from the vessel by back flushing. Then fifth step is known as washing of cake if required, and sixth step is known as drying of the filter cake which are deposited on the filter leaves on both side, and the last step is known as cake discharge from the filter leaves. When the washing is not required at that time, after hill removal step, drying of the cake will be followed and then cake discharge. When the slurry containing coarse solids particles less than 5% weight by volume strength, at that time after installation of filter leaves in a vessel, directly its filtration will be followed. So first installation, after installation, filtration of aqueous slurry will be carried out without applying pre-coat layer on the number of filter leaves. So the first step is known as installation of filter leaves in a vessel, assemble required number of the filter leaves according to the capacity of the vessel and desired thickness of the filter cake. We have to maintain the space between the filter leaves, cover the head of the vessels and check all bolts. Second step, pre-coating or filtrate layer if required, if the fine solids are there required to remove. It is used when the contaminants are gelatinous and sticky, leading to pore blocking, and when a clear sparkle filtrate is required. The slurry of suitable filter aid less than 0.1 to 0.5% weight by weight is required to operate first in order to make thin layer that is in between 2 to 5 millimeter for improving the rate of the actual slurry, rate of filtration of the actual slurry. Third step is filtration of a slurry. This process of filtration of actual slurry is carried out by forcing it under the pressure through the slurry inlet provision into a vessel with slight vacuum. The slight vacuum we have to start through the provision available at filtrate outlet. Hence, the liquid of slurry passes through the filter cloth, enters the drainage screen, and goes through the filtrate outlet into the receiver. And the solids which are having the size larger than the pores of the fine mass of filter leaves deposited on it. So the solids known as filter cake of the slurry deposited or retained on the surface of the filter leaves depends on the size. So in this way, solids are deposited on the filter leaves. So after some times it will be stopped. When it is stopped, once the filtration cycle is completed, air or gas is blown into the vessel and the hill remover process is carried out. The slurry hill that surrounds the leaves is pushed and displaced downwards until it reaches the lowest part of the leaf stack. So remaining hill slurry is evacuated back to the feed tank by a special deep pipe which are located at the bottom of the vessel to make vessel free from hill slurry. The fifth step is known as cake drying. So if washing is required, it will be followed. Otherwise, direct drying of cake is followed. So the hot air continuously passes over the deposited cake until the captive moisture is reduced to a minimum desired level and the cake appears as a dry cake. So hot air continuously passes over the deposited cake for drying purpose. So after drying of the cake at suitable moisture level, at this stage, in cake discharge stage, releases the air pressure of the system and open the cake outlet and vibrate the filter leaves stack using either a pneumatic vibrator or it is electrically operated vibrator through a large butterfly valve to discharge the cake. The cake outlet must be interlocked with a pressure sensor to avoid opening under pressure. After cake discharge on some filter leaves, the filter cloth or mass may be backwashed with water to dislodge and remove any cake residue adhered to the medium. So, backwashed with water will be carried out to remove any cake residue adhered to the medium. Now, how the leaves are arranged in the vertical vessel. So, this animation showing the working operation of vertical vessel, vertical leaves filter. So these are the arrangement of each filter leaves. So number of mass are arranged and the frame is fixed. So in this way, each filter leaves of rectangular shape are positioned on the project provisions available on the horizontal shaft. That horizontal shaft also serves as filtrate outlet. So number of rectangular shaped filter leaves are arranged according to the capacity of vertical shape vessel. Then the head is closed with help of the quick fixing bolts, and then filtration is carried out. So depends on the types of slurry. Under the positive pressure, it is introduced through slurry inlet portion, and vacuum is started through filtrate outlet. So in this way, the solids are deposited on both sides of the each filter leaf, and the filtrate is collected from the filtrate outlet portion into the receiver. The solids which are deposited on number of filter leaves by vibration, the filter cakes are removed, and from the bottom outlet it will be collected in separate tank. So in this way, the vertical vessel containing vertical leaf filters are going to work for solid liquid separation of dilute suspension. Now the second animation showing working of horizontal pressure leaves filter. So here, this horizontal pressure leaf filters are commonly used for sulfur preparations. So heavy duty filter elements are arranged, that is rectangular in shape, and this is the chain for moving of the whole vessel to and fro. Both sides there are the exchangeable inlet manifold for all filter leaves. Teflon scraper blades are there for removing of filter cakes. So in this way, the whole vessel is closed using this horizontal pressure leaf filters using hydraulic pressure. So this animation indicates how the horizontal pressure leaves filters work as per the required capacity for sulfur preparation. Now some manufacturers have patented method for removing and washing the cake. The examples are available in literature. First is Dore Oliver Sweetlet filters. They are designed to open the bottom of the tank, and the cake is discharged by blowing compressed air from inside. The second example is there, that is Niagara filters. The entire nest of leaves riding on rails are withdrawn out of the pressure tank, air pressure applied, the cake blown out and dried. Once dried, they are blown off the medium by air. The third example is known as Wallace filters, originally developed in the United States for the sugar industry. They are designed to rotate the circular filter leaves at approximately 1 revolution per minute speed during the filtration operation to keep the solids in suspension and achieve a more uniform cake. So Wallace filters are used to achieve a more uniform cake type leaf filter. Most leaf filters in pressure units are stationary, but in Wallace these filters are rotated. Now again there is a reflection spot. You have to take your note and pen. If you know the answer of this question, you answer it. What are the merits of a pressure vessel containing leaves filter? Pause the video, think and answer this question. What are the merits of a pressure vessel containing leaves filter? If you have completed your answer, play the video once again and verify your answer. The merits of a pressure vessel leaves filter. First, it is versatile filtration equipment for batch process filtration of slurry containing less than 5% weight by volume solids. So slurry can be filtered from any shape vessel, maybe vertical or horizontal, hollow cylindrical vessel. It requires less flow space if vertical vessel is there, minimum labor and efficient washing. Cake can be tested simply by immersion the leaf filter in a vessel of water. Cake can be removed by the use of reverse air flow. So cake can be easily removed by the use of reverse air flow. It is versatile as the filtration area can be varied by using number of filter leaves operated under positive pressure or slight vacuum or combined with these two. Pressure up to 800 kilopascals means 8 bar can be applied for batch scale filtration of dilute slurry. And last, ease of handling and identify any type of leakage in any filter leaf in the tank or vessel. The cloth or woven mesh screens that cover the leaves of horizontal vessel may be accessed easily once the stack is pulled out of the vessel. In case of the cake bridges between the leaves, ease of washing of the filter medium with high impact jets. So these types of provision improve the washing. On vertical vessel, the head cover must be unbolted and removed to assess the filter leaves stack. So filter leaves position we can easily assess by opening whatever the bolts available on the head cover. Mechanically simple in construction since there are no complex sealing glands or bearings. And last one is suitable to handle incompressible filter cake and sometimes for slightly compressible cake. So for batch process under the pressure as a driving force, these filter leaves are used to handle incompressible filter cake and slightly compressible cake available in dilute suspension. So these are the merits of a pressure vessel leaves filter. Now again there is a reflection spot. You have to take your note and pen and write down the answer of this question. What are the demerits of a pressure vessel containing leaves filter? Pause the video, think and answer it. If you have completed your answer, play the video once again and verify your answer. What are the demerits of a pressure vessel leaves filter? High headroom is required for dismantling the leaves from the vertical vessels. Large floor space is required for discharging the cake from the horizontal vessels. For horizontal leaf filter, 1/2 the filtration area is lost because the underside of the leaf is not used for filtration due to the danger of the cake falling off. Discharge of cake may be more difficult in this case. requires attention on a regular basis to safety device and automation features. Maintenance cost for cleaning and installation. Space must also be located for the cover, which may be either hinged or removed. Recommended to have a special rig that will be hold the leaf element for maintenance. Now again there is a reflection spot. You have to pause the video, take your note and pen and write the answer of this question. What are the uses of a pressure vessel containing leaves filter? Think and answer it. If you have completed your answer, play the video once again and verify it. There are several uses of a pressure vessel leaves filter. In chemical industries for organic and inorganic salts, dyes, chemicals and plasticizers preparations purpose, it will be utilized. In pharmaceutical industries for pharmaceutical intermediates, syrup, bulk drugs, antibiotics, intravenous solutions preparations, it will be used. In petrochemical and biofuel industries for crude oil, sparkle, refining purpose, for LPG purpose, lubricating oil making purpose and sulfur preparation purpose, so it will be used. In edible oil industries for bleached, winterized, deodorized, hydrogenated, fractionized oils, de-waxing catalyst, mineral oil and sulfur preparations, these types of filtration equipment can be used. In herbal extraction plant, in micro nutrient recovery, in lube oil refining purpose, filter leaves are utilized. In glucose industries, edible oil distillation, high vacuum separation by molecular distillation, pressure vessel leaves filters are utilized. In dyes and pigment manufacturing, it will be utilized. In fertilizers and pesticides manufacturing, it is utilized. And in brine manufacturing as well as in catalyst recovery, these types of filtration equipments are utilized. But you remember, the solid content must be less than 5% weight by volume. Depends on the capacity of the vessel and the number of leaves filter, its size and structure. So this is the end of session 9. I hope you understand very well about filter leaf filtration equipment. Thank you. Happy learning. If you have any questions about this session 9 on filter leaves, submit it to my email ID.